Hello, everyone. This is your Saturday evening KRQE.com webcast. Here's Ian Schwartz with a quick look at the forecast.
Thanks, Tim. We had a windy day today, a lot less wind for tomorrow. We'll keep an eye on a storm that arrives Monday, but it really is weakening as it gets into the New Mexico area. We can expect spotty rain activity, and that's probably even a generous word. The areas that will be favored will be the mountains. We could even squeak out some lightning and thunder with these storms, but very, very weak as far as pulling moisture in. We'll have a lot more cloud cover, but don't expect a whole lot of rain out of those clouds, and that'll be the similar situation here in Albuquerque. We'll be calm with mostly sunny skies up until about Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving day does look great. Friday, though, another storm pulls in. It'll increase our winds and give us another crack at rain, but it's kind of mimicking this storm we'll see on Monday with not a lot of moisture. So the week ahead in Albuquerque looks pretty good. Tim?
Thank you, Ian. A fatal crash last night involving a repeat drunk driver who crashed head-on into an SUV packed with people. Four of those people were kids. It happened yesterday evening on Highway 550 south of Bloomfield. San Juan County Sheriff's officials say 36-year-old Howard Hasisa Jr., now charged with his fifth DWI, was driving the wrong way when he crashed head-on into an SUV carrying seven people. A 50-year-old woman inside the SUV was killed. Two small kids inside the SUV were airlifted from the scene. One of two passengers inside Hasisa's vehicle was also killed. Besides the fifth DWI charge, Hasisa is also charged with two counts of vehicular homicide and seven counts of great bodily injury. He is now at the San Juan County Detention Center. New Mexico State Police and law enforcement agencies across the state have already kicked off their annual winter Super Blitz campaign to catch drunk drivers and possibly save some lives. The Super Blitz includes statewide checkpoints and saturation patrols now through early January. This year's campaign includes new sports-themed TV commercials encouraging people not to drink and drive. A big marijuana bust in Roswell. Police there are not saying much about the investigation, but they are showing off what they took off the streets last night. More than 40 bricks of marijuana packaged for smuggling. According to police, a couple of officers stopped the suspicious vehicle around midnight last night. Inside the car were two people and all the marijuana sitting in the back seat.
From what the narcotics guys are saying, it's in excess of $75,000 on the street.
Well, the officers actually stopped the vehicle in the suspect's driveway. Police are not saying yet where that was, nor are they identifying the suspects. One of the officers was bit by a pit bull while trying to arrest the suspects. The dog was shot. The officer was okay. Also found during the course of the investigation, a sawed-off shotgun and more than $10,000 worth of stolen property. The investigation continues. Stay with KRQE for more news and weather updates. I'm Tim Maestas. Thanks for logging on.